We're at the Museum District Bed and Breakfast right here on Grove Avenue in Richmond, Virginia with Anna Currents, and we're in the dining room. It's absolutely gorgeous.
Thank you.
Yeah, you've been doing this for about 3 years?
3 years. Mm-hmm.
And as soon as you opened, it just...
As soon as the website went up, people from all over the world, all over the country, and locals have stayed here.
It's tucked away, but it's right in the middle of everything.
Mm-hmm. The Fine Arts Museum across the street. Carytown is 2.5 blocks. The Fine Arts, right past that, is the Virginia Historical Society.
And you've had visitors from all over the world, but also a lot of local visitors, too, who might just mm-hmm. be getting away?
Particularly people with a 2-year-old who get a babysitter. We're surrounded by fabulous restaurants. So people come get a little staycation, one or two nights, a getaway.
Tell us about the space and all of the different amenities that the Museum District Bed and Breakfast has.
The Judge Rea Suite has a very luxurious bath. It's like having your own apartment in the city. And the John Lane Suite is a 3-bedroom, 1.5-bath suite. But I don't have strangers sharing baths. So if one person or one couple rents the John Lane Suite, that's fine with me. But if parents have 2 grown children or a grandma and a child or something, they can take that as well. And then the carriage house is just a really sweet little house out back. And it's one room and one bath, but it's really darling.
The Judge Rea Suite has a little sleeping porch.
The sleeping porch has room darkening shades, so you can sleep till noon, or you can open them up and be in the treetops.
And it definitely feels like a getaway when you go in, and it does mm-hmm. have that apartment flair. It feels like a little mm-hmm. apartment in the city.
It does, yes.
So it's very comfortable here. There's room to spread out for everyone. You have a library and mm-hmm. the front parlor.
Yes, I have a lot of picture books of the Richmond area and Virginia as a whole. And there's something about B&Bs. My clientele is more attracted to the books than almost anything. So they're the same clientele as a bookstore.
The kitchen area is your domain mainly because mm-hmm. people are enjoying the breakfast when they're here. But tell us about that experience. You use a lot of local products too.
I do. All of my bacon is from Belmont Butchery 2 blocks away. I buy my croissants from Can-Can, the French bistro. I buy my fresh squeezed orange juice. There's only one place in town you can get it, really, truly fresh squeezed orange juice. And so everything is bought right here and very fresh, organic, local. I don't buy large quantities. I go shopping often.
So Anna, when you have visitors staying, not only do they get to explore the area, but they come down and relax with wine and cheese?
Yes, and they're given the option to have wine and cheese privately in their room, and if they want to do that, that's perfectly fine. But 97% of people want to come down and sit around this table and talk with me or talk with other guests. And if they've all been out sightseeing, they share their stories, or they just share stories, period, mm-hmm. even if it's not sightseeing. So we have some really fun social hours for the wine and cheese.
They're discovering the great company
yes.
in this great bed and breakfast. Well, discover for yourself the Museum District Bed and Breakfast right here on Grove Avenue across from the Virginia Museum of Fine Arts. Anna's a very gracious host. Thanks for having us.
Thank you.